anointing you don't respect
does not work for you. Thumping, how you shumel.
Just anointing you don't respect.
Tocho yo usai thumping.
It doesn't work for you.
Are you shumel?
You can be surprised. You are in a church where other people are prospering, and yourself you are suffering. It goes by how far you respect that anointing.
Yeah, kauru tocho we thumpa kaka.
How do you respect anointing? You must worship God with faithfulness.
Alright,
for example. Can I give you an example?
Amen.
Eh?
Amen.
Alright, I'll give you this example. I was one time went to synagogue. When I was there, I used to go there in the night to pray in the church. The way people respect anointing there. You know, you'll be surprised they are sleeping there, you know, very close to where prophet walks here.
They come
crying, praying. You know, when I was there, I heard that many of them, what they are doing, they don't do it in their church. You will see people rolling there. And you question if they were doing this for a long time. These people were supposed to be far. Our problem is, you know, we don't respect anointing in people, we respect people.
But
you understand what I'm trying to say? So this is the mistake now. If you have, like we've got pastors here.
Let's take, come on, brother. Come on, brother.
Let's take this pastor here. You've got 20 people in the church. Those 20 people, for them to be blessed. For them to do what he cannot do. Because this man like this is a pastor. They have got anointing that these members need. And the anointing that will come from God. So when you are under his ministry, you get two things. What is in him? What is coming from God? But you will never get what is coming from God if you don't first get what is in him.
Amen.
Can I say that again?
Amen.
You will never get what is coming from God if you don't get what this man is having. How do you get what this man is having? Is to be so much submissive under the anointing. There's anointing. When you see him, you don't look at him. You see who's behind him. Who gave him what is having? I don't know if you are hearing me.
Amen.
So our problem is, listen, the reason why many of you are still empty is because you are undermining these people. This man, when you have got members like there, if they carry on respecting this person, you know what will happen? Not respecting only. Fearing God will call this man. They will obey whatever he says. You know what will happen? God will start to give them. Come. Come here. That's how God works. This man is like this. He will take this one. God.
God
will take from him and say one. When he say one, she will turn like this. Stand here. Stand one place. Come here. You just turn. It means you are given now. Okay? He takes again. Turn. It takes again. Dish. Now, this pastor now is no longer him alone here who's speaking what he's speaking. You have got some people, one, two, three. Because these people are facing there. Now,
You three, come and stand here. Come and stand here. Face there. God will take here and put to three people. And the three come, stand here. Just like that, three come, stand here. And from there, you find this church growing. And from there, God will bless this people. And look here, from here, after God took what this man is
in,
and give to this one, give to that one, give this one, he will say, this one is three people, this one is three people, this one is three people. Now this one, three people, three people, three people. Six people, six people, six people, six people. Now it's no longer pastor speaking. It's no longer him. Even these people are speaking. From the church will grow. They are facing one direction. Meaning they are in one accord. God add many. From there God will say, hey, this man can't do it alone. And the Holy Spirit says, okay, on those three first, we can bring someone close to him. Come here. Let's call this one to be like this one. But let's take more and bring it double here. I don't know if you're hearing me. From there, the same process. And God said, the job is too much now. Let's bring this one. Let's bring that person there. Let's take this one here. This is the job that has been done by the Holy Spirit. From now, God said, no. Let me visit this man. I want to speak with him. Hear me. I said, you know what?
What's again?
I want you to have branches. You send this one to Zimbabwe.
Zimbabwe.
Send that one to
America.
America. I don't know if you hear me. From there, this man will say, face there. Please, go and stand to Zimbabwe.
Zimbabwe.
Go Zimbabwe.
Zimbabwe.
You go America.
When now America,
this is the work of the kingdom.
Go and
sit down. Go and sit down. I will elaborate one day what I'm
saying.
How many of you are hearing me? How many of you? So look here. Once you have this kingdom mentality, you begin to understand that I can't fight these people. I mean, if now you don't have kingdom mentality, what will happen? Come. Face there. Stand. No one face there. You always come. Move forward. Come. This way we get clashes, division. Now you can't breathe, you can't breathe. Now you are standing in one place, you are competing. This one will go that side, that one will go that side, that
one will go
the church scatter. Go and sit down. I will elaborate one day what I said. I'm just trying to show you this is what now is happening to church. No one serve God and submit until he's released. Whoever is there now, he doesn't know the anointing that must come from him, from this man or this woman. That will enter them to 10 until their time. Everybody now will be just saying, I want to be a man of God. This man is delaying me. If I say, yeah, okay, what will happen? Other people are eating money. You are here for money.
Until it is
you are here for money. You will miss the reality of the ministry.